Engineers at Northwestern University have added a new quality to electrical microchips, the ability to fly. The new fly microchip, also known as a microflyer, is about the measurement of a grain of sand and does not have a motor or an engine. As an alternative, it takes to the air with the wind, similar to the propeller seed of a maple tree, and then spins through the air like a helicopter as it descends to the ground. By analyzing maple trees and other types of wind-dispersed seeds, the technicians were able to optimize the aerodynamics of the microflyer, ensuring that it falls at a slow velocity and in a controlled manner when dropped from a high altitude. This activity helps to stabilize its flight, ensures distribution over a wide region, and enhances the period of time it spends in contact with the air, making it perfect for assessing air pollution and respiratory diseases. Due to the fact that they are the tiniest human-made flying structures to date, these microflyers have the potential to be packed with ultra-miniaturized technology, including sensors, power sources, antenna for wireless communication, and embedded memory for data storage. In an interview with the Journal of the American Chemical Society, Northwestern's John A. Rogers said the team's goal was to add winged flight capabilities to small-scale electronic systems with the hope that these capabilities would allow them to allocate highly functional, miniaturized electronic devices to interact with the environment for purposes such as contamination monitoring, population surveillance, and disease tracking. They were able to accomplish this by drawing inspiration from the biological world. Nature has built seeds with extremely sophisticated aerodynamics over the course of billions of years of evolution. They took those design thoughts, tweaked them, and implemented them to electronic circuit platforms as a result of their collaboration. He is the Lewis Simpson and Kimberly Query Professor of Materials Science, Engineering, Biomedical Engineering, and Neurological Surgery in the McCormick School of Engineering and Feinberg School of Medicine, as well as the Director of the Query Simpson Institute for Bioelectronics. Rogers has been recognized as a pioneer in the fields of bioelectronics. Professor Yonggang Huang, the Jan, and Marcia Achenbach, Professor of Mechanical Engineering at McCormick, were in charge of theoretical work for the project. The majority of people have witnessed a maple leaf's whirling spinner seed spin through the air before gently landing on a sidewalk of a street. This is only one example of how nature has created creative and sophisticated strategies to boost the survival of numerous plants over the course of their evolution. Instead of remaining rooted in one location, otherwise sedentary plants and trees can reproduce their species over long distances and occupy large areas by dispersing their seeds widely. It is likely that evolution was the driving force behind the advanced aerodynamic qualities displayed by many types of seeds, said Rogers. This is because these biological structures are engineered to fall softly and in a controlled manner, allowing the user to interact with wind patterns for the longest amount of time feasible. Using completely passive, airborne mechanics, this characteristic increases lateral dispersal to the greatest extent possible. As part of their research for the microflyers, the Northwestern team looked into the aerodynamics of a variety of plant seeds, with the Tristilatea plant, a flowering vine with star-shaped seeds, serving as the most direct source of inspiration. Three-bladed wings on the Tristilatea seeds allow the seeds to catch the wind and descend with a leisurely, rotating spin. Many other varieties of microflyers were conceived and manufactured by Rogers and his colleagues, including one with three wings that were optimized to have shapes and angles that were comparable to the wings of a Tristilatea seed. A full-scale numerical model of how air circulates around the device to stimulate the gradual, controlled rotation of Tristilatea seeds was conducted to determine the optimal structure. Huang was in charge of the modeling. In addition, the computational modeling enables for quick design optimization of the fly structures in order to achieve the smallest terminal velocity, Huang explained. With trial and error experiments, this is difficult to do. The structures were then built and tested in the lab using advanced methods for imaging and quantifying patterns of flow developed in collaboration with Leonardo Camurro, an accomplished professor of mechanical engineering at the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign, who was also part of Rogers' research team. The resulting structures may be created in a wide range of sizes and shapes, and some of them have qualities that can compete with those found in nature. Mr. Rogers asserted that they believe that they have defeated nature, at least in the narrow sense of having been able to construct structures that fall with more consistent trajectories and at sluggish terminal velocities than identical seeds that we could see from plants or trees. They were also able to construct similar helicopter flying devices on scales that were significantly smaller than those found in nature. Important because device shrinking represents a dominant growth path in the electronics industry, with the ability to fabricate ever smaller sensors, radios, batteries, and other components as a result. Using another well-known oddity as inspiration, Roger's team created the devices which were inspired by children's pop-up book. His team began by fabricating flat, planar geometries that served as precursors to flying structures. After that, they attached the precursors to a rubber substrate that had been gently stretched. Upon releasing the tension from the stretched substrate, a controlled buckling process occurs, causing the wings to pop up into clearly delineated three-dimensional shapes. According to Rogers, this method of creating 3D structures from 2D precursors is effective because all currently available semiconductor devices are constructed in planar layouts. They will be able to take advantage of the most cutting-edge materials and manufacturing technologies currently being employed by the consumer electronics sector to create entirely standard, chip-like designs, flattened in the future. Then, using concepts that are comparable to those of a pop-up book, they simply turn them into three-dimensional flying shapes. The microflyers are made up of two parts, millimeter-sized electronic functioning components and wings that are attached to the body. As the microflyer falls through the air, its wings interact with the surrounding air, resulting in a gradual, stable rotational motion that is easy to control. In order to avoid the microflyer from relinquishing power and haphazardly plummeting to the earth, the electronics are distributed low in the middle of the aircraft. Sensors, a source of power that can harvest ambient energy, memory storage, and an antenna that can wirelessly transport data to a smartphone, tablet, or computer, were all used in the demonstrations by Roger's team. In the lab, Roger's team constructed one device with all of these components in order to detect airborne particles. Another example is the incorporation of pH sensors, which could be used to evaluate water quality, as well as photodetectors, which could be used to assess solar exposure at various wavelengths. Rogers envisions a scenario in which vast numbers of devices are dropped from a plane or a building and widely spread to monitor environmental remediation activities following a chemical spill or to assess levels of air pollution at various altitudes, among other things. In Rogers' words, the vast majority of monitoring systems employ bulk instrumentation data, gathering locally at a small number of points within a spatial area of interest. In order to create a wireless network, we anticipate a huge number of miniature sensors that can be placed at a high temporal and spatial density over a vast region. But what about all of the electronic garbage that has accumulated? Rogers has a strategy for dealing with this. According to recent research on bioresorbable pacemakers, his lab is already developing transitory electronics that can be harmlessly dissolved in water once they are no longer required. His team is now employing the same materials and processes to create microflyers, which will naturally decay and vanish in groundwater over time as they have done in the past. Given that they fabricate such physiologically momentary electronic systems using degradable polymers, compostable conductors, and dissolvable integrated circuit chips that naturally vanish into ecologically sound end products when exposed to water. Roger says that the company understands how difficult it may be to recover large collections of microflyers, but in order to address this worry, these environmentally resorbable versions dissolve spontaneously and without harming the surrounding environment. If you are given an opportunity, would you like to experience this winged microchip? Let us know down in the comments below. If you want to see more interesting videos like this one, do subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get VIP access to our videos. Thanks for watching, guys, and with that said, I'll see you in the next video. Cheers!